So, hey, movie lovers, we're here today to talk with Jay Baruchel about his latest film, Goon: Last of the Enforcers. Thanks so much for joining us here today, Jay. And
Thank you for having me.
we're very excited. And I guess the first thing we really want to know is how do you follow up the greatest hockey film in Canadian history?
Oh my God, thank you. That's such a please tell everyone. But yes, with a great deal of care and caution. We didn't rush this movie out a year or two after the first one came, because it wasn't made for cynical reasons. It wasn't made just to sort of keep some sort of bit of energy going. It was because we wanted to do it right. And so it took us some time. And so, like, my writing partner, Jesse, and I, we literally wrote the first draft of Goon 2 5 years ago. And yeah, and so it's you do it carefully, and you do it with, like, the most important thing being we have to have a respect and pay homage to our fans
Yeah, absolutely.
and to our characters. So it's about finding a movie that they both deserve.
Wonderful. Yeah, because we were wondering, like, how do you approach the film knowing that there is this fan base now with expectations and
It's like the best kind of problem to have. It's like we're not making it in a vacuum like we were on the first one. When you create something, you hope people will like it, but you don't think it's going to hit the way that Goon hit. And so yeah, that's all of a sudden we have tall boots to fill, boots that we cobbled ourselves, mind you. And so we just, like, yeah, it's got to be done with care and patience, and it's always got to come from the place of the heart. It's got to come from just wanting to tell an awesome story.
And you guys definitely did that. It's a
Thank you.
great film. We're really excited. It's going very wide in our circuit, so we're really
Awesome.
excited about that. And you were just saying, like, you had been working on this project for a while in the writing and developing. So what made this the right time to bring the Halifax Highlanders
That's
back?
a very good question. It's simple. Because our director wouldn't return. My buddy Michael Dowse, who directed the first one, he's my general, one of my best friends, and one of my mentors. And Jesse and I built this script for him to direct. When circumstances dictated that he couldn't, I'd be lying if I said I hadn't thought I could do it, but I'm too humble to suggest as much. So it was our star, Sean William Scott, and one of our other stars, Marc-Andre Grandin, who each on their own asked me if I'd think about doing it. And obviously I said yes very quickly, because this is all I've making movies, specifically writing and directing movies, is something I want to do since I was 9 years old. It predates my acting career by 3 years even. So I was always in acting because I love movies, not the other way around. So yeah, I've been waiting for this since I was a kid.